So one of the first things you start doing when working in the area of linear algebra is you start studying systems of equations. So what we're going to do in this example problem is we're going to study kind of the simplest system of equations that you can have. We're going to study just a system of two equations, and each of those equations just has two unknowns. So we're actually going to be able to think of this system of equations as a pair of lines in 2D that we can easily plot, and we're asked basically the following question. Given these lines for equations, do these lines intersect? Do they have a solution? And if so, where is that solution at? So in part A, we're going to look at this system of equations. 3 times x2 minus x1 is equal to 9. And the other equation is x2 plus 2x1 is equal to a negative 4. So this is the system of equations. And we can visualize these as lines. And we're trying to figure out, is there a solution? Do these two lines intersect? So there's kind of two different ways to solve this simple system of equations. The first one is what I call the substitution method. This is pretty straightforward. Basically, what we can do is we can rearrange this second equation right here. If we move the 2x1 to the other side of the equation by subtracting 2x1 from both sides, we end up with this equation right here. X2 is equal to a negative 2x1 minus 4. And then we can use this expression for x2, and we can plug it back into our other starting equation. 3 times x2 minus x1 is equal to 9. So let's go ahead and do that right here. I'm going to replace x2 with minus 2x1 minus 4. So if I do that, I end up with this equation right here. I'll go ahead and distribute the 3. So that's a negative 6x minus 12 minus x1 is equal to 9. And then I can collect like terms. I have minus 6x1 minus x1 is a negative 7x1. And if I move the 12 to the other side by adding 12 to each side, 9 plus 12 is 21. So I'm almost there. I can divide both sides of this equation by a negative 7, and then I'm left with x1 is equal to a negative 3. So using substitution, I've solved for the value of x1. It is equal to a negative 3. And then if I go back to this starting equation for x2, I can replace x1 with a negative 3 and solve for x2. So if I do that, I get x2 is 6 minus 4, or 2. So using kind of very simple, straightforward, basically high school algebra, we were able to determine that yes, these lines do intersect, and they intersect at the point minus 3, comma 2. So that's one way to kind of solve a system of equations like this and find out where these lines intersect. Another way to do it is what I call the graphical method, where we actually just solve for the intersection graphically. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to start with the first equation, 3x2 minus x1 equals 9, and I'm going to solve for x2. So I'm going to put the x1 to the other side, and then I'm going to divide both sides of the equation by 3 to isolate x2, and I'll get this equation. And then I can do the same thing for my second equation. Move the 2x1 to the other side, and I end up with x2 equals a negative 2x1 minus 4. Now what I'm going to do now is I'm going to plot both of these in the x1 and x2 plane. These are basically just lines. From this first equation right here, this is a line in the x2, x1 plane that intercepts the x2 axis at 3, and it has a slope of 1 third, because this is just an equation of a line. So if I draw a dot right here when x2 is equal to 3, and then I draw a line that has a slope of 1 third, that means for every 1 it goes up, it goes to the right 3. So this blue line right here has a slope of 1 third. That's what that line looks like. And then I can do something similar for the other line. It has a y or x2 intercept of a negative 4, and it has a slope of minus 2. So if I draw the point minus 4, and then draw another point that goes to the left 1 and up 2, that has a slope of negative 2, I have this orange line right here. And just by looking at these two lines, the orange line and the blue line, we can indeed see that they do intersect at the point x1 equals negative 3, and x2 equals 2. So we get the exact same answer like we should because this is the same system of equations. Let's do something similar for a slightly different set of equations. So 2x2 minus 4x1 is equal to 4, and x2 minus 2x1 is equal to a negative 1. So I'm going to do this in reverse order this time. I'm going to go ahead and do this graphically first. So I'll move the 4x1 to the right, and then divide both sides of the first equation by 2 to get this expression. And then if I isolate x2 in the second equation, I get this. So again, I'm going to think of these as just plotting in the x2 and x1 plane. The first equation, right here, has a y-intercept of 2 and a slope of 2. So I can draw that line in the plane. It has intercepts right here at x2 equals 2 and has a slope of 2. And then this equation right here has an x2 intercept of negative 1, and it also has a slope of 2. So if I plot that line, it intercepts at negative 1, and it also has a slope of 2. So graphically looking at this, what we see is that we have parallel lines. So since they're parallel, they don't intersect, which means that there is no solution to this system of equations. Another way of saying it is that this system of equations is inconsistent. They don't match up. There's no solution. Let's go ahead and do the substitution method to see what happens there. So I'm going to go ahead and use this second equation, which is already written nicely in terms of x2. x2 is equal to 2x1 minus 1. And I'm going to substitute that into the, or set that equal to the first equation, right? I have two expressions for x2. x2 equals 2x1 plus 2, and x2 equals 2x1 minus 1. I'll just set those equal to each other. And then look what happens. I have an 2x1 on both sides, so I can subtract 2x1 from both sides. And then I'm left with a negative 1 is equal to 2, which is obviously nonsense. This is called a contradiction. A negative 1 is not equal to 2. The reason this has occurred is because this set of equations is inconsistent. It does not have a solution. So when you're using the substitution method, if the system of equations does not have a solution, you'll eventually encounter something called a contradiction, something like this, that is nonsensical. And at that point, you conclude that the system of equations does not have a solution. Or in the case when we're talking about simple lines like this, that means the lines do not intersect. Obviously, this concept extends to higher dimensional lines. We could have tried to draw lines in 3D. I couldn't draw that very well, so that's why I did 2D. But the same concept would apply. If we had three equations with three unknowns, x1, x2, and x3, if those equations have a solution, you can actually picture that solution as the intersection of lines in a three-dimensional space. If there is no solution, then those lines never run into each other in one spot among all three lines. So you can kind of continue that to 3D, 4D, 5D, and so on. But we just stuck with two dimensionals here because it's easier to plot and think about.